Mr. Speaker, sir, I rise to present the budget for the year 2019-2020. The recent election, which brought us to this august house today, was charged with brimming hope and desire for a bright and stable new India. Like never before, India celebrated its democracy by coming out to vote in large numbers. Like never before. Voter turnout was the highest at 67.9%. Every selection, young, old, first-time voters since the first general election, women, all turned up to stamp their approval of a performing government. Through their unambiguous and firm mandate, they have reaffirmed putting the nation first. The people of India have validated the two goals for our country's future, that of national society and economic growth. The first term of Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi led NDA government stood out as a performing government, a government whose signature was in the last mile delivery. Between 2014-2019, we provided a rejuvenated center-state dynamic, cooperative federalism, GST council, and a strident commitment to fiscal discipline. We had set the ball rolling for a new India, planned and assisted by the Niti Aayog, a broad-based think tank. We have showed by our deeds that the principle, reform, perform, transform, can succeed. On many programs and initiatives, we had worked on unprecedented scale. Average amount spent on food security per year approximately doubled during 2014-2019 compared to the preceding 5 years. Number of patents issued more than tripled in 2017-2018 as against the number of patents issued in 2014. Our last mile delivery stood out, and the unknown citizen in every nook and corner of our country felt the difference. Mega programs and services which we initiated and delivered during those 5 years will now be further accelerated. We shall further simplify procedures, incentivize performance, reduce red tape, and make the best use of technology, just as we did earlier. I am confident we will achieve our goals. Our economy was at approximately US$1.85 trillion when we formed the government in 2014. Within 5 years, it has reached US$2.7 trillion. Hence, it is well within our capacity to reach the US$5 trillion in the next few years. In the interim budget of 2019-2020, presented in February 2019, we gave ourselves a vision for the decade. With this vision set before us and with the mandate given by its people, we are determined to take India to that height that it richly deserves. I strongly believe that with the clear-headed leadership of Honorable Prime Minister, we can achieve our goal. The Indian economy will grow to become a $3 trillion economy in the current year. It is now the sixth largest in the world. 5 years ago, it was at the 11th position in purchasing power parity terms. We are in fact the third largest economy already, only next to China and the USA. To attain this and more, we need to continue undertaking many structural reforms in the last 5 years. We saw many big reforms, in particular in indirect taxation, bankruptcy and real estate. While these reforms were happening here in the parliament, the common man's life was being changed through mudra loans to help him do his business. And through several programs, it was being ensured that his Oblikhar kitchen had become smokeless. His Oblikhar house got electricity connection, and woman's dignity was respected with the provision of toilets in homes. The common man was served even as major transformational reforms were being rolled out. And for this to continue, we need to invest heavily in infrastructure, in digital economy, and on job creation in small and medium farms. Respected Speaker, sir, it took over 55 years for the Indian economy to reach $1 trillion. But when the country and her people's hearts are filled with hope, trust, and aspirations, we in 5 years added $1 trillion. Today, we are nearing a $3 trillion level. So, when we aspire to reach a $5 trillion level, many wonder if it is possible, if we can appreciate our citizens' goals of human pursuit, filled with their inherent desire to progress, lit by the dedicated leadership present in this house. The target is eminently achievable. All of India's private sector industries, small, medium, or large, have played a substantial role in growing our economy. I recall the words of an eminent industry leader who said that his company's growth has always aligned itself with India's growth before and post independence. So, if before independence, India Inc. understood Swadeshi, today they understand Make in India. We do not look down upon legitimate profit earning. Gone are the days of policy paralysis and license quota control regimes. India Inc. are India's job creators. They are the nation's wealth creators. Together with mutual trust, we can gain, catalyze fast and attain sustained national growth.
If you have liked the video, hit the like button and consider subscribing.